name is Martin Casado. I'm an SVP and the GM of the Networking Security Business Unit, and I'm also a fellow. So what is network virtualization and why has it become so big? Network virtualization is very simple to think about, right? While traditionally network functionality has been in hardware and that underlies so many of the problems in the industry around manual operations, time to provision, it's difficult to secure things, it's difficult to innovate. Once you move it into software in the hypervisor at the edge, those problems go away. This has totally changed the dynamics of the industry. Now you can consume network functions as software. I mean, I often tell customers the following. I say, listen, you've got a big data center, you run a lot of very critical things. I'm gonna totally change all of the network services you have, and I'm gonna do it with a software install. And in fact, after you purchase NSX and you install it, just don't use it. It'll be sitting there, the bits will be there, and then as you want, you can update it. And if I develop a new service, I can provide you this new service and software, and you can install it. So the whole idea and the whole model of operating and consuming networking now moves from this kind of very archaic, very ossified hardware model to this new software model. So network virtualization, like compute virtualization, is a very general technology, and its use is going to evolve over time. Yet we do, and we have identified three primary use cases that are driving the majority of the sales. And these are the following. So the first one is simply automation, which is automating the provisioning and configuration of networks and securities. So anytime the business wants to reduce the time it takes to provision and configure a network, we can take that time down to zero, which clearly provides business benefits. The second one is security. Because products like NSX, because network virtualization runs on every server, we can apply security services to every packet within the data center. That's opposed to the traditional model where the security only sits at the perimeter and only sees the traffic that leaves the data center, which honestly can be less than 20% of the traffic. The last use case we see are HA and DR use cases between data centers. These are things like moving workloads between data centers, allowing a new data center to come up with all the security configuration, all the network configuration when another one fails. And because there's a huge move to, say, public cloud, and there's a huge move to multiple clouds for these reasons, this is a very instrumental technology for that. So one thing that's really cool about where we are now is we have a number of awesome examples of customers using NSX for significant events. I mean, one I like to talk about was actually on main stage at VMworld in San Francisco in 2015, which was DirecTV used NSX to help with the number one pay-per-view event in like the history of mankind, which was the Mayweather-Pacquiao fight. We also had on main stage Tribune Media talk about how they use NSX to move, you know, I think it was 140 workloads in a number of months to this entirely new operational model. And so we're seeing a number of customers use it in a number of deployments. And in fact, the customer base is so broad that we think it's as general purpose as compute virtualization. So how critical is the need for network virtualization? You know, when we started with developing the technology, we were unsure who would adopt it and why they'd adopt it. I mean, I thought early on, maybe this is more suitable for larger customers, or maybe this is more suitable for certain segments. And it turns out network virtualization is as generic as compute virtualization. And in fact, when we talk to customers, like our 500,000 customers, over 70% say they're interested in network virtualization. So I think it is solving a fundamental business problem. And not only is it solving a fundamental business problem, that problem is shared by the majority of customers out there. So this is really an exciting time for us. I mean, we've done a lot of work, we're seeing massive adoption, we've created this platform, and now we can use this platform to really change and introduce new services nobody's ever thought about before. And so I'm very excited by what we've done, and I'm very excited about what we're about to do.